Hello and welcome to my Farsi class. Today I'm going to teach you another verb tense that's a little bit tricky in Farsi, but in fact it's quite easy if you understand the formula. Okay, we have already talked a little bit about this, but this is just to review and maybe you know you can catch a few extra points. So, let's focus on a simple verb to go, raftan. So as you remember in the previous video, in the previous lesson, I explained that when you look at the infinitive, you will notice that the infinitive in Farsi will give you access to the past stem. Now, knowing that, today we're going to learn present perfect tense. Now, you may ask me why past stem is connected to present perfect tense. Well, the answer is simple. For us, present perfect in reality is a variation of past. So we don't refer to this tense as present perfect. We refer to it as past transferred. What does it mean? It means something happened in the past, but the effect is transferred into the present. Let me give you an example. So in English, when you say, I have turned on the light, what does this mean? This means you flipped the switch 2 hours ago, but there is still light in your room, right? So the action actually took place in the past, but the effect is still valid for the present time. This is why we refer to this verb tense as past transferred. In another word, we think of this verb tense as something that happened here, then we put a hook and we kind of drag it into the present time, right? That is why when you look at this tense in Farsi, you will notice that it is made based on the past stem. So I have gone, because for us this is a past transferred, is raftam. Raft is your past stem. The e is the hook that I told you about that we put here to drag this thing into the present time. And of course, the ending, as you're familiar with, right? So for I have gone, we have raftam simply because this for us is a variety of past. It's the past that is being dragged into the present tense by this hook e. Okay? So you have gone. Obviously, you can guess rafte-i, and so on and so forth. This is, again, just to remind you, this is informal you, e. If you're talking to a person with whom you're supposed to be formal, let's say a senior citizen, your grandfather, your boss, or if you're talking to more than one person, let's say to a group of people, you will need to use in rather than e. So rafte-in will mean you plural have gone, or you formal, singular formal have gone. So, one more time. Present perfect, past transferred. Remember that. It has nothing to do with the present tense for us in Farsi, okay? So don't get confused. Use past stem, the hook, and the ending. Now, just a quick note here. When you listen to people actually speaking, or if you're watching movies in Farsi, you may not really hear something like raftam. What you will hear actually is raftam. Okay? So raftam or raftei or raftein, on paper this is how it should be, but in reality you will hear raftam, rafti, raftein. Okay? Just be mindful of that. Now, many of my students ask me, how do I differentiate? If I hear raftam, how do I differentiate between this and simply when someone says raftam? That we just learned, no? The simple past. I went. How do we differentiate? The differentiation is quite subtle. You have to listen carefully. When someone says raftam, the stress is here. Raftam. But when someone says I went in the past, the stress is right at the beginning. Raftam. Raftam. Okay? So one more time. Raftam, raftam. Okay? Stress shifts between this tense and this tense. Okay? Now, this is very subtle. You need a lot of practice. But I wanted to put it out there in case you're actually listening to people for you to understand that not everything that starts with raft is just a simple past. In any case, you know, it needs a lot of practice. Okay? Now, if you're interested in learning more about different verb tenses in conversational Farsi, or just, you know, practice other tenses or other verbs, Don't forget to check out my book, 110 Conversational Verbs, and I will put a link under the video for you to check out. And stay tuned because I will be posting more lessons about verbs. Okay? See you soon. Ta bad. Khudafiz.